Parents, students, family, and friends. This is Dr. Damon, proud principal at Murrell Dobbins CTE High School. I want to just thank you and welcome you as we prepare to celebrate our students for a long journey that ended like no other. These 4 years, we have seen the best of times, but even most recently, we have experienced some of the worst of times. But through it all, through their perseverance and passion, our children, through the village we've created, have demonstrated that we have the grit that it takes to make it in this world. Join me on this journey as we close one door and open another that will make a difference in this world.
I am Tiana Neal, Senior Class Secretary of the Class 2020. Please stand and recite the Pledge of Allegiance with me. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
My name is Evelyn Scott, and I will be performing the national anthem for the virtual graduation class of 2020. Please place your right hand over your heart. Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
Thank you. Congratulations.
Hi, my name is Valerie Martin, and I am from the class of 1979. And if you are participating in this event today, then that means that you weathered the storm and you stayed the course. And for this, I say congratulations. Lift every voice.
Good afternoon, family, friends, staff, and class of 2020. My name is Jeremiah Rodriguez, and I'm the senior class president here at Murrell Dobbins. The day that we have all been very anxiously waiting for is finally here. Most of us have not even imagined being at this point in our lives, but we are here now, and I just want to congratulate every single one of you seniors that has pushed through these 4 years, no matter what obstacle has been in front of you. Now the question becomes, how will you move forward with all the challenges and obstacles that you will continue to face in the lifetime you live? And the answer is quite simple. You deal with them by remembering that at the end of the day, you can be your greatest enemy as well as your greatest successor. You determine your own success. So all outcomes of your life will be dependent on you. Please continue to thrive for the best and always remember that you have support even in times when they may not feel like it. We live in a new world, a world where we demand and will see change. All I wish for is equality for the same people that have helped me in so many ways my entire life. When will the nightmare stop? When will the pain in Black communities end? I've grown up in Black communities my entire life, so I know that pain firsthand. Collectively, we will fight and continue to seek justice for the loss and injustices of so many innocent Black lives. Black lives matter, and it will be heard worldwide. I have had the very special privilege of being a part of a new chapter at Dobbins. This school has helped shape us all in so many ways. The class of 2020 will be one that is remembered in the history books. You should all be very proud of how far you have come. Now, how far will you go? How far will you fight to get there? Those are the key questions. I would like to welcome you to the first ever virtual commencement ceremony for Murrell Dobbins CTE High School. Thank you.
Hey, class of 2020, it's Mr. Charles here, your community school coordinator. Listen, really just wanted to leave this message to say congratulations to the class of 2020. Unfortunately, we're not able to be together. I really wish we could be, but COVID-19 thought otherwise. But the graduation must go on. I'm so proud of you guys. I'm excited for you, and I can't wait to see what the future holds for you. In a few moments, you will be graduates and alumni of Murrell Dobbins CTE High School. Remember this, we've entered to learn and we exit to serve. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Special, 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 big congratulations to Dobbins High School, class of 2020. This class that will go and not only change the community or the city or the country, the class that will change the world. Dobbins High School is the strongest high school in the city of Philadelphia. Yes, a lot of schools have shut down in the city, a lot of things have happened in the city, but guess what? You still standing. Yes, you. I'm looking at you because you're the next leader. You come from a home and from a bloodline of leaders like Hank Gathers, college basketball player, Gregory Kimball, NBA player, Dawn Steadley, head coach of a women's basketball at a university, Doug Overton, retired professional basketball player. Do you realize who you are and how lucky you are? I'm counting on you, especially even to the teens who have been through their own personal storms, who have made themselves stronger to be able to prepare themselves to go out and change the world. We need you, the next generation, to teach us what to do, how to serve, and how to love. We are counting on Dobbins High School, the class of 2020, to take us all into another level of success. I love you. Peace and blessings. Do what you do. Go hard. Peace.
Greetings, class of 2020. Today, let's reflect on this school year and celebrate you as seniors, as you have prepared to become productive citizens and attending higher learning institutions. No matter what career and technical education program that you had studied throughout the years, our main concern was to prepare you to become the best person that you could be. However, allow me to leave you with a few more pieces of advice. Work hard, persevere, because it is very rewarding. Be humble. Yes, you are brilliant, you're smart, you're talented, you're athletic, but so are others. Be humble about your accomplishments, but be quick to compliment another. Smile. I know it seems a bit too much, but it helps people to treat you kind and makes you more approachable. Be courteous and respectful. Get involved with other programs and organizations to make your significance more visible. And follow the number one golden rule. Do as to others as you want others to do unto you. And finally, to the class of 2020. You have made your presence known here at Dobbins, but there is so much more to come in the years ahead of you. Continue with your growth mindset. Keep reading, putting your best effort forward, and keep smiling.
Congratulations to the Dobbins class of 2020. My name is Bo Kimball from the class of 1985. Also friends of the late Hank Gathers, also in 1985. Congratulations, and I want to just say how proud we are of all of you guys for getting the work done and becoming part of the Dobbins alumni family. For people that don't know my background, I'm a retired NBA basketball player, and I'm here to tell you all of my dreams have come true. So whatever occupation that you guys pick, whatever trade at Dobbins that you have, explore that to the best of your abilities. But remember, don't be afraid to take on other opportunities as I've done. I've been blessed to be an entrepreneur most of my life outside of basketball, but it all began with my Dobbins education. So there's an old saying, multiple streams of income. So don't be afraid to try something new. More importantly, stay true to your passion, do the best you can, and in the Dobbins spirit, let everybody know how bad we are, okay? So you can be as smart as you want to be, as ambitious as you want to be, as rich as you want to be. Just remember, the only person that can stop you is you. Go Mustang forever. Love you guys. Dobbins Mustang forever.
Hi, Marie Patterson here. I am the president of the parent board for Murrell Dobbins High School. It is my esteemed pleasure to say, we did it. We did it together. And to all the graduates, just remember, anything you want to accomplish, all you have to do is start. Put one foot in front of the other and just start. I am very proud of you all. Now, on to your next journey, Mustangs for Life. 2020 grades.
On behalf of myself and all the English teachers at Dobbins High School, congratulations, class of 2020.
Greetings and salutations to the resourceful, remarkable, and resilient class of 2020. I've been thinking about you guys a lot lately. I was planning to come to your graduation. I miss you guys a lot. You know, it's actually appropriate that we have your graduation for the very first time in Dobbins history, on YouTube. I mean, if you think about it, you guys have been making videos, TikToks, and putting stuff on YouTube for years, since you came to Dobbins, or before. So, if I think back to 2016 when we first met, and I gave you the assignment to write a screenplay, if any of you had written a screenplay entitled My Senior Year, the Class of 2020, and included a pandemic, that closed the schools for months and months and killed 110,000 Americans and forced Dr. Damon to move from the friendly confines of deliverance to YouTube for your graduation ceremony, I'd say, you lost your mind. But here we are. It's what actually happened. And I'm really hopeful and grateful for the opportunity to meet you guys and be with you guys. And I can't see you today, but you're in my heart. And I will tell you this, keep living the dream, keep those cell phones handy, keep making those films. Remember, just a month, a young lady with a cell phone captured the death of an innocent man on her cell phone, and that film has changed the world, and the sky's the limit for the changes you guys will bring about in your years ahead. You're our hope for the future. Things are happening with you guys. God bless. Congratulations. All the best.
Hello, Dobbins Mustangs. This is State Representative Danilo Burgos. I take this opportunity to congratulate the class of 2020. I want to congratulate your parents also and your teachers for helping you achieve this goal, one of many that you will have in your lifetime. I encourage you to be strong and to fight for your dreams and to continue to work hard to achieve all the goals that you have set for yourself. Thank you, and I hope that you continue to be the change that you want to see in your community. God bless.
Good morning. I'm Senator Sharice Street, and this message is for the Dobbins class of 2020. Out of the night that covers me black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank God wherever he may be for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloodied but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters now how straight the gate, how charged with punishments the scroll. I am the master of my fate, I am the captain of my soul. Dobbins class of 2020, this is a poem that has inspired generations. And I read it to you that it inspire you. That in these times where there is violence and there is destruction, where there is disease, I say you can be the answer. You can bring peace to a world that is chaotic. You can bring justice to a world that so desperately needs it. You can create the future that you want to have for yourselves, your community, and future generations. God has given you an opportunity to make the world the place you need it to be. And while circumstances may seem to have bloodied up our community, we shall forever remain unbowed. And the step you take today by graduating prepares you to help bring about a better future. The future that you wish to see. A future that we all need you to create. Congratulations, Dobbins Class of 2020. I have great confidence in you, and I believe you can bring to us the future we all so desperately hope for. God bless.
I'm Council President Daryl Clark, and I want to congratulate you on your achievement today, graduating from Murrell Dobbins Career and Technical Education High School. Even though we're in the middle of the coronavirus pandemic, I want you to know I am extremely proud of you. Wherever your life journey takes you, the values you've displayed so far, hard work, responsibility, and caring for your family will serve you well. From all of us in City Council, congratulations.
Hello, Class of 2020. I'm Helen Gim. I'm your City Council member on the Philadelphia City Council. And I just want to say congratulations. I am so proud of you. As many of you know, the world that you lived in just a few months ago is radically different today. And the world you're about to embark on in the next few months is going to be even more different. But I will say this, it's waiting for you to make its mark upon it. Because the world that we're going to enter into, we don't even know what it's going to look like right now. We do know that we need people who love healthcare more than ever. We do know that we need people who can go to work and try to find small businesses that deal with people's current needs. We need people who are creative, who are brilliant, who love music and dance, who are artists and scientists and builders and engineers and people who will build community. That is you, Class of 2020. So wherever you go over the next few months, just know that I want you to find your voice. I want you to find the thing that makes you shine brighter than any other person around you and that makes everyone look your way. Because that's the kind of energy we're going to need to remake this world. And this is more than just about you or your family. It's about the life of the city of Philadelphia and about the world that is yet to come. So, Class of 2020, you are our hope, you are our biggest hope for a better world yet to be made. I can't wait to see what you're going to do. Congratulations, and enjoy the day.
Congratulations, Dobbins High School Class of 2020. I'm William Hyde, Superintendent of the School District of Philadelphia, and I'm here, along with everyone else, to congratulate you on all that you have accomplished. We know that we didn't want the year to end like this for you, but nonetheless, you have everything that you need to achieve great things. So on behalf of the School District of Philadelphia, congratulations. We are so extremely proud of you. Take care. Be well. Congratulations.
Hey, Dobbins Class of 2020. Congratulations, man. You guys did it. It was tough. It was a tough time of year, especially at the end, man. It was really hard, but you all stuck to it and you did it. And you're part of one of the best traditions in high school in Philadelphia. Many graduates of this school were great leaders, athletes, educators, and just you're going to follow in their footsteps. And I spent a lot of time at Dobbins in the last 4+ years, and I really feel part of the family there. Your community dinner nights and stuff that you've done around the holidays, and the way you look after each other and respect each other is just a wonderful thing. I'm very happy for you. Things will get better. We'll get back to some sense of normalcy. And I want to wish you all well. Congratulations to you and to your families, to your teachers, and all the people who made your life what it is today. And always remember to thank them for it, and always remember to pay it forward to the next group of young people coming. So have fun, enjoy, be safe, be healthy, wear your mask, and good luck, y'all. Love you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Siani Roberts-Jordan. I am Class of 2020's Vice President. Today, we are all here to celebrate a very, very special occasion. Today is the day that we all graduate. Today is the day that we all become alumni of Murrell Dobbins CTE High School. Speaking of alumni, we have a very, very special guest. She's a Basketball Hall of Fame player and coach. She's a three-time Olympic gold medalist and was elected to carry the United States flag at the opening ceremony of 2004 Summer Olympics. Her name is Dawn Staley.
Dr. Damon, faculty, staff, parents, and 2020 graduates of Murrell Dobbins Career and Technical Education High School, thank you for giving me a moment of your time today. As a Dobbins alum, I am honored to speak to you, but saddened that it has to be in this way. We are surely in uncertain times. There are times we've read about in history books from days long gone, a faraway time when technology was rudimentary and penicillin was the cure for all medical concerns. Today is an unfortunate way we become history. We become the people who lived through a pandemic. Now your children will read about the pandemic of 2020 in their history books, and you'll be able to give them a firsthand account of what it was really like. You'll tell them stories of quarantine and long lines at grocery stores. You'll tell them about social distancing and mandatory masks. You'll tell them how, for the first time in the country's history, not only doctors, but nurses, sanitation workers, grocery store clerks, truck drivers, and the always unsung teachers were our heroes. You'll be able to pinpoint with accuracy exactly when the pandemic occurred, your senior year at Dobbins Tech. You'll drudge up memories of senior year milestones missed and will explain how all your classes, even your graduation, was done virtually. You'll share all the highs and lows of the start of 2020, and in the end, you'll tell them how you've made it through. And thinking of making it through, I am going to share something with you that I have not had the time to reflect on until now. For us older people, quarantine has had a way of reinforcing us to slow down. And in doing so, has freed up time for us to look at our lives with renewed perspective. When I was asked to give this address, it was during one of the most reflective moments. And coincidentally, I was thinking about my teenage years, my years at Dobbins. When I reflect on my 18-year-old self, leaving Dobbins, leaving North Philly, and going to college, I was reminded how much I thought I didn't know and how unprepared I felt. I remember feeling great angst, but it wasn't necessarily about the prospect of being in college. I had basketball, and I knew I would get through college. What I didn't know and what I didn't have the maturity to articulate at the time was whether or not I was prepared to be in a world that wasn't North Philly. The question was, had North Philly prepared me to be a citizen of the larger society? Had I learned anything that could be generalized to a world outside of the world I had become accustomed to? In my quarantine reflections, I realized something really important about being raised in Philadelphia, specifically North Philly. It prepares you to conquer the world and adversity in a way most other neighborhoods and cities can't. I thought long and hard about the things I knew that others did not. I recall situations I've been in after college, after leaving college, and the ways in which I handled each. I remembered how I used to think my college friends and teammates were so silly, how they would get themselves in the craziest circumstances or situations I saw coming a mile away. They called me names like skeptical, distrustful, or suspicious, which I was fine with. I knew better than to run into a building when everyone else was running out. They didn't. At the time, for lack of better definition, I called them silly or sheltered. But in thinking critically, what they really were was unprepared. The towns and cities from which they came had not prepared them to be in the real world. So things like leaving a bike unlocked but expecting it to be there when they returned, and being seriously surprised when it wasn't, was their hard lessons. Lessons I had learned long before. Back then, for the life of me, I could not understand how they so easily missed certain environmental and social cues, how they just walked through life without the intuition or instinct that came so naturally to me. And thinking back now, I realized how prepared I actually was. Being raised in North Philly, there are certain characteristics and abilities that you inherit that just come with the territory. You're always going to be aware of your surroundings. You're going to have this innate sense of knowing when something is about to jump off. You're going to know who you can mess with and who to stay away from. You're going to be able to sum up someone with just a glance. You're going to have this weird North Philly confidence and think you're much harder than you actually are. And most importantly, you're going to be brave, courageous, strong, whether you want to or not. Of course, at 18, I didn't recognize these characteristics as skills. In fact, I didn't recognize them at all. They were a part of me and how I moved in the world. The first time I noticed the difference between myself and my peers was at an Olympic team practice. Most of my teammates were from the South and Midwest, with one player from Los Angeles. I was the only player from a big East Coast city. They would always tell me I was different, that there was something in the way I carried myself that was noticeably different to them. I never noticed anything different about me until one day, North Philly came out. I remember so vividly, we were doing a drill and our coach separated the team into two groups. Somehow my group kept losing, and a punishment for losing was running. By our third loss, I was pretty sure our coach was cheating for the other group. Each time we ran, I got more and more upset. Then if I lose fairly, I can accept my consequence. But you can't cheat me and expect me to have a great attitude about losing. This is how the Philly in me kicked in. Number one, be aware of your surroundings. I noticed the coach kept huddling together with, which didn't usually happen during drills. I knew something was up. Two, know who you are, or know who you can mess with and who you can't. Our head coach was really stern, so I called the assistant coach over and asked her what was going on. She gave me the you know what's up look. Three, sense when something is about to jump off. After my group's fourth straight loss, the group started teasing us, and my group began mumbling threats under their breath. It was getting tense. Number four, sum up people in just a glance. I looked at the faces of my group and knew they were mad, but also got the feeling they were afraid to say anything. Five, the weird North Philly confidence. I stood on the line after our seventh straight loss and said, I don't care what you do, you're not going to break me. Six, be brave, courageous, strong. After our ninth loss, we lined up to run, and as soon as the whistle blew, I took off, screaming, you can cheat us if you want, but you will not break us. We will bend, but we will not break. We will not break. I made sure to lead the pack. I ran hard and stayed out front, screaming my head off, so everyone in the gym, including my cheating coach, could hear me. My teammates had my back and took my lead. We band together as a unit and stood firm in our conviction that we were ready to take on whatever they threw at us, cheating and all. Two things happened that day. My teammates were finally able to use that incident to illustrate their point that I operated differently. And my coaches later disclosed that the drill was used to identify the group's natural leader. I was one of the youngest and smallest players on the team that year, but stood head and shoulders above the rest, being only myself. By now, I'm sure you ascertain my belief that being from North Philly is my superpower. It's what I consider the foundation of my success and of what I am most proud. I would not have been the same player had I been born in any other city. That I know for sure. My approach to the game, my fearlessness, my ability to anticipate action and outcomes, all Philly. You have the same abilities, but chances are yours have yet to be tested. But they will. Know that you are prepared, in most cases, overprepared. The world will not throw anything you can't handle. I promise. I have been all over the world and have probably met thousands of people throughout my career. And what I can tell you is that my Philly roots, those characteristics I described, have kept me safe and sane. My intuition has always been my best guide, and I rely on it for everything. If it tells me it's not safe, I don't go. If it tells me someone is not right, I leave them alone. You are armed with the same intuitions and instincts. Trust them. There is nothing special about me, really. I have literally sat in the same classroom you sat in and have walked the same streets you've walked. In essence, I am you. There is absolutely no reason your success can't surpass mine. My skill was, of course, basketball. But being that you're completing your high school education at a career and technical school, you have undoubtedly honed your own skill sets. And although our talents may be different, what we have in common is we grew up the same. The education North Philly unintentionally provides, vigilance, perceptiveness, confidence, and courage will serve you as much as your chosen skill, and the two should never divorce. Whether you decide to go into the workforce or to college, go understanding that you are already uniquely prepared and your greatness and success will only be measured by the effort you give. Nothing else. Give great effort in everything you do. About 100% of you won't remember who your graduation speaker was 20 years from now. And that's okay. What I know you'll remember is the moment in time when the world shut down. However, what I hope you remember are my words. You are exceptionally positioned to be a great citizen of this world. Be fearless. Know on occasion you may bend. It happens. But don't you ever break. Congratulations, class of 2020. Be well. Be great. Thank you.
Hello, and congratulations to the class of 2020 of Dobbins High School. On behalf of the Alumni Association, it gives me great pleasure to announce the following recipients of these awards. The top five ranking graduating seniors are: ranking number one, Siani Creamer. She will receive an award in the amount of $1,000. Ranking number two, Niaja Gonzalez. She will receive an award in the amount of $1,000. Ranking number three, Sadea Taylor. She will receive an award in the amount of $500. Ranking number four, Nicole Council Brown. She will receive an award in the amount of $500. Ranking number five, Brianna Parrish. She will receive an award in the amount of $1,000. Congratulations to those recipients. The Carolyn Cole Munson Book Award was established in honor of our alumni president. This award goes to Anthony Rodriguez in the amount of $250. The Charles M. Whiting Book Award. He was the first African-American principal of Dobbins. This award goes to Brianna Parrish in the amount of $250. The Class of 1974 Edward Magliocco Memorial Award goes to Sardea Black in the amount of $500. The Class of 1974 Xander Dougherty Award goes to Hector DeVell in the amount of $300. The Class of 1975 Citizenship Award goes to Jordan Urquhart in the amount of $200 and Zahara Jenneret in the amount of $200. The Ann Switzer Award for Female Scholar Athlete. From the Girls of the 50s, Joanne Chalmer, Class of 52, Joanne Phillips Fitzsimon, 52, Joan Brownie Sider, 53, Mary Higgins, 54, Daisy Jones Barrett, 52, and that award goes to Exnet King in the amount of $250. Congratulations to all the recipients.
Hey everyone, congratulations to the Class of 2020. We're so proud of you. You guys were the first freshman group that I had when I came to Dobbins, so it's an honor to be able to present these awards to the seniors. These are the Dobbins Mustang Athletic Scholarship Awards. The first award presenting is the Robert Smith Athletic Award for $50. This is being presented to senior Shereem Rose. He was a member of the varsity football team, the varsity bowling team, as well as the varsity baseball team. He's also a dedicated student of the culinary department who assisted in multiple school-wide events. And in the fall, he'll be working for the next year and then attending Lincoln Tech for welding. The next award up is the Hank Gathers Athletic Award for $75. This is being presented to our standout basketball star, Tashawn Bailey. Tashawn played varsity basketball. He was first team All-Public this year. He also led the team in scoring. In the fall, he'll be attending Northampton Community College, where he'll be suiting up and playing basketball for the Spartans. Our next award is the Dawn Staley Athletic Award. This award is being presented to our senior, Sherelle Moore. Sherelle played 4 years of varsity volleyball, had a 3.7 GPA, and plans on working full-time in the restaurant field after graduation. The next award is for the Raheem Brock Athletic Award. This is $1,000. This is being presented to Amir Brown. Amir has been a dedicated member of the basketball program since he arrived here and is during his 10th grade year. He's carried a 3.3 GPA for his career at Dobbins, and in the fall he plans on attending Manor College, where he'll be playing basketball and suiting up for the Blue Jays. And our final award is the other half of the Raheem Brock Award, which is for Siani Kramer. Siani is a standout varsity cross-country, soccer, indoor, track and field athlete. In addition, she carries a 3.91 GPA and the number one class rank for Dobbins Class of 2020. In the fall, she'll be attending IUP, where she actually got a partial scholarship for running track and will be competing for NCAA and the Crimson Hawks. Congratulations to everybody and the whole Class of 2020. Can't wait to see you guys on Thursday. See you.
Hi, I'm Ms. Munson and I'm here representing the math department at Dobbins, and I'm here to announce the recipients to our Math Excellence Award. The recipients are Ijanetta King and Siani Kramer. Congratulations.
And the Murrell Dobbins Shupack Social Studies Award goes to William Upchurch. Congratulations, William.
My name is George Kokotis, and I'm here to announce the Social Studies Awards. The first award is the Robert Smith Award, and that goes to Niasia Gonzalez. The second award is the Social Studies Award, and this goes to Saidia Taylor.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Roos, and I'm proud to be presenting the 2020 English Excellence Award to a Dobbins Mustang who demonstrated A-plus work ethic and who earned an A-plus in the course for the year. The English Excellence Award goes to Najaya Brinkley. Congratulations.
And the award for Barber Student of the Year goes to... Oh, it's a tie. Maria Medley and Jeremy Slaughter. And the award for Mustang Cuts Hair Hustler of the Year goes to Diamond McGee, congratulations.
Good afternoon. This year's 2019-2020 Fashion Design Awards goes to two outstanding students in fashion design. Each award is worth $250. Our first recipient of the Designers Inc. Fashion Award is Kamaya Jean. Our second recipient of the Stephanie Simpson Fashion Award is Shania Fowler. Congratulations.
Hi, everyone. I am Ms. Gant, the cosmetology teacher at Murrell Dobbins CTE High School. I am so proud of the graduating class of 2020. Congratulations, you guys made it despite our world's current situation. You have made it. Congratulations. It is my honor and my privilege as an alumni of Dobbins myself to present the recipients for the scholarship for the cosmetology department. Our recipients this year will receive $100 as a stipend towards their books. Our first recipient is Nicole Council Brown. Our second recipient is Jada Flantroy. Our third recipient is Jordan Urquhart. Congratulations.
Ms. Marjorie Kloss, I'm culinary instructor, and I'm here to announce the awards for culinary excellence above and beyond the call of duty for the class of 2020. Kenyatta Jenkins, Anna Plez, and Shareem Rose. Thank you so much and best of luck.
Congratulations, class of 2020 at Murrell Dobbins CTE High School. This is your year. Here are the following awards in the following categories. Graphic Arts Award of Achievement goes to Daquan Akers and Siani Martin. The Graphic Art Awards for Entrepreneurship goes to Daquan Akers, Brianna Parrish, and Ariana Hill. Congratulations to you all. This is your year.
Good morning, Dr. Damon, faculty, staff, family, friends, and the Murrell Dobbins graduating class of our Year of the Lord 2020. My name is Samuel Jackson, and I am the brother of Prenetta Jackson Hughes, a 1975 Dobbins graduate who went home to be with the Lord in November of 1986. It has been our family's privilege each year since 1987 to proudly remember my sister by presenting the Prenetta Jackson Hughes Award to the Dobbins graduating senior with the highest academic standing in the business school.
It is especially an honor this year as we face such uncertainty in our world that we push through with the same tenacity demonstrated by the achievements of our well-deserving awardee. My name is Jordan Jackson, and my Aunt Prenetta was an excellent student, a model citizen, an exemplary employee, a wonderful wife and mother, and one who placed her hope and her faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Hi, I'm Camilla Burnett. This year's award recipient embodied a lot of the same qualities that my Aunt Prenetta possessed, such as hard work, dedication, respect for authority, a spirit of excellence, all the while uplifting others along the way. It is with my great pleasure, on behalf of myself and the entire Jackson family, to present this $1,000 scholarship in the name of Prenetta Jackson Hughes to Jeremiah Rodriguez. Jeremiah, on behalf of my family and myself, we wish you all the best. Thank you.
Greetings, Dobbins class of 2020. I'm Dr. McLaughlin. I taught mathematics at Dobbins until I retired a few years ago. I'm privileged to say a few words about my friend and colleague, Mary Catherine Ladany. In September 2008, fresh out of college, Mary Catherine Ladany joined the mathematics department at Dobbins as a brand new teacher. Katie, as we called her, showed remarkable talent right away. She had a gift of making math make sense to her students, and they loved her for it. Her students spend the entire year learning and having fun, and at the end of the school year, over 20 juniors signed up for an extra year of math with Ms. Ladany. It was to be an elective course in calculus, a subject which had not been taught at Dobbins in years, and the students were excited. It was an inspiring plan, but it was not to be. A freak accident took Katie from us while she was jogging in Fairmount Park. The Dobbins community, along with Katie's family, was devastated. In the aftermath, a path opened to the furtherance of Katie's hopes and dreams that Dobbins students would carry their skills in math into the world with them. In remembrance of Katie and her wonderful work, her family, John and Patty Ladaney, established a scholarship to be awarded to a senior math scholar beginning in 2010. In the intervening years, 11 scholarships have been awarded. 1 year, 2 scholarships were given. And this year marks the 11th year that the family has made the award at the Dobbins graduation. We regret that the current conditions prevent the presentation in person. John Ladaney has been a friend to Murrell Dobbins over the years. Please join me in giving a warm Dobbins welcome to the virtual graduation of Dobbins High School to John Ladaney. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Please excuse my work from home attire and appearance. I could really use some help from one of Dobbins' barbering students right now. Our daughter Katie was killed in an accident about 11 years ago in August 2009. This was after her first year of teaching at Dobbins. This will mark the 12th scholarship awarded in her memory to a Dobbins student and brings the total of these grants to nearly $50,000. Recipients have attended colleges across the Mid-Atlantic states studying a variety of majors. It gives me great pleasure to hear from these students, sometimes years after they graduated from Dobbins, about the impact this award has had on their lives. Let me now take a moment to tell you about our latest winner. She began her academic career not liking math at all. She felt that she just couldn't get the hang of it. Being a very shy person and not wanting to stand out, she didn't want to raise her hand to ask for help. Thankfully, our student recognized that this was a problem requiring action. What's a shy person to do? Instead of taking the easy route of hiding at the back of the classroom and hoping for the best, she deliberately moved to the front to be closer to the teacher. This helped her to focus and follow instructions more closely. Her positive attitude gained the teacher's attention, and her skills and confidence improved. She felt better about raising her hand to ask for help when needed. She also began to notice that the questions she asked were shared by many of her classmates. So by asking good questions, she was helping fellow students with the lessons too. More helpful tips included reviewing math lessons from previous years, completing all of her assignments, and assisting other students with the work. As a result, she finally recognized that she could learn the material on her own. This student still asks for help whenever she needs it, but she feels better prepared for the work facing her as she goes off to college. Our winner has been accepted at Harrisburg University and plans to study forensic science. I am very pleased to announce that the 2020 recipient of the Mary Catherine Ladaney Scholarship for Excellence in Mathematics, a $4,000 award, is Zahara Jenneret. Congratulations.
On behalf of the Cary T. Pacifico Family Foundation, I'd like to congratulate all of the seniors in the class of 2020. While it's true that you guys will have a unique mark in history, it's not that will define you. Your legacy will be the great things that you do going forward. Having this experience this year, I believe, will make you stronger, more resilient, and more motivated to do great things to support everyone around you and take care of each other. So once again, on behalf of our family, I wish you guys great luck going forward and a great freshman year.
It gives me great pleasure to announce the Principal's Award. The individual receiving this award has presented themselves as an amazing student representing Dobbins as a member of the Today's Scholars, Tomorrow's Leaders Ambassador Program. This individual has also represented us at Temple University and their Power Program. He has also attended the PFEW program at Lycoming University, studied abroad in Spain. This individual serves currently as our senior class president. and will be attending Cheney University on a full ride scholarship. It is my honor and privilege to present the Principal's Award to Jeremiah Rodriguez.
Hello everyone, my name is Sincere Mitchell, Senior Class Treasurer of Class 2020. I would like to present this wonderful gift of gratitude to one of Dobbins' most amazing alumni, Coach Staley.
Greetings, family, friends, staff, and Dobbins Class of 2020. I come for you today at the 2020 Valedictorian, the first ever virtual graduation. I know that this isn't how we planned for this day to go. Part of my saying, so we want to continue to push through and celebrate all that we accomplished over the past 4 years. I have to be honest, I was nervous when I found out that I earned the role of Valedictorian. It was such a heart-racing moment for me. And looking back, I realized that one of these goals shouldn't be done just because you see other people doing it. It should be done for the sake of yourself and wanting to see your own growth. And as for my fellow classmates, I would like to tell you to dream big, but also have goals, because dreams without goals are just thoughts. You shouldn't be afraid to take risks, because once I took those risks, I realized there was nothing to be afraid of at all. How would you know what would happen if you never tried? Be sure to do what you feel passionate about. Take ownership of your future, because you're in control of it, not anyone else. Even if you're not sure what your next step in life would be, don't ever give up. No matter what, you have to keep moving forward. I want everyone to take a deep breath and think about what's stopping you from wanting to be moving forward. Is it that you're too tired, no motivation, or just you? Giselle Washington once talked about never understanding the concept of having something to fall back on. I'm sure people had told you to have something to fall back on just in case things don't go your way. He said he doesn't want to have anything to fall back on. He wants to have something to fall forward on, so at least he'll know what he's about to hit. I want everyone to take that advice, set a goal, have a plan, get your dreams. Tell yourself every day goal of your future. Get up and start walking. Even if you have to crawl, just get up. Your biggest fears can change your largest growth. Thank you, Dobbins, for the lessons you have taught us. We will take those lessons with us to the next phase in life. I wish you all the best, and remember to lead like a Mustang.
My name is Penny Greenberg, and I have the privilege of being the senior sponsor. Congratulations to the class of 2020. Every year, we, the faculty and staff, have the pleasure of seeing our seniors graduate, and we always keep them in our hearts with fondness. This year, the class of 2020 will be remembered forever because of the special way that you graduated. You are a class that has experienced a different way of finishing school. I believe these times will make you stronger and more resilient to the challenges that life sends your way. As you embark upon your life's journey, I wish you success and may all your dreams come true.
Hi, class of 2020. This year has been a ride, but it is finally a done bun. It has been a pleasure getting to know all of you this year. I have seen you all rise to the occasion considering everything that's happening right now. I am proud of your success, and I am thankful for everything that I've learned as a first-year school counselor, all because of you. I just want to leave with three pieces of advice. As you can see, life can sometimes be unpredictable. There are things that will happen that are unexpected, but that does not take away from the goal. You must continue to push. The goal doesn't change, just how you get there may be a little bit different. I know many of you are thinking, I'm grown now, but this is just the beginning. Please keep your family, your friends, and those who support you close. You are still in the beginning stages of independence, but that does not mean that you have to do this alone. You will appreciate the help, so take it. Be willing to give. No, I'm not just saying money, but if you want to give me $5, I will take it. Be willing to give your time, an ear, or even your voice. Your life will impact so many others around you. Be present and use your story to build others up. You are now Dobbins alumni. Take pride in all you have accomplished here at Dobbins, and be sure to take it out into the world. I wish you all nothing but the best and look forward to seeing all of the success to come. Congratulations again. I'll miss you all. Stay safe, stay healthy, and see you soon. Bye. Congrats.
Well, well, well. Dobbins senior class, the class of 2020. Woo! You finally made it. The time is now to celebrate these 4 years of hard work and accomplishments. We know that it may not be the way that you have wanted it to be, but in the end, you will get that diploma. So take this time to celebrate with your families and know that your work was not in vain. Do whatever you can do safely, and good luck in the future. Woo woo! Class of 2020.
It's your year, it's your moment. Enjoy every second of it. Congratulations, class of 2020. Graduating seniors, Devon Bright Blunt, Michaela Brown, Kamaya Jean, Danara Martin, Ariana Mitchell, Denaya Stones, Nakia Weldon, Salimatu Carbo, Keisha Pierce, Shania Fowler. Congratulations, fashion students, class of 2020.
Hello, my name is Mr. Cobbs. I'm the sports marketing teacher at Murrell Dobbins CTE High School, and I would like to congratulate the class of 2020.
Hello everybody, this is Matthew Conboy, building property maintenance teacher at Murrell Dobbins. I'm here today to wish the following seniors congratulations on a job well done. You made it, you're graduating high school, and you did it under difficult circumstances, so good job. Congratulations to Deshaun Thomas, Jasir Jillian, Kareem Gordon, Rachel Bowman. Great job, everybody.
Hi, everybody. This is Joseph DeAndrea, the SEL over at Dobbins Technical High School. And I just want to say congratulations to a few of the seniors that this year that are graduating in the 2020 class at Murrell Dobbins High School. First, I want to start by saying congratulations to Anna Pelez. Congratulations on graduating 2020. Helen Richardson, congratulations. Caitlin Oliver, congratulations. Sire Peterson, congratulations. And Siani Martin, congratulations. You guys definitely deserve it. And I hope you guys go to college or get jobs or get started and be successful right away. Woo!
Congratulations, class of 2020. This is Miss Dean Smith. You guys know me as Miss D. I am a business teacher here at Dobbins CTE High School. I'd like to read off a few of our graduating business students for class of 2020. Deshauna Carmichael Ransom, Hector Delvon, Anthony Rodriguez, Makai Hope.
Edward Brown, Siani Creamer, Jessica Dillard, Catherine Furgis, Alexis Grisby, Kiowa Scott.
Jeremy Slaughter, George Williams, Diamond McGee, Yaudi Yancey, Tyler, my son, Arrington, Tyshawn Bailey, Cheyenne Chambers, Najee Evans, Natalie Hill, Maria Medley, Dejan Thomas,
Congratulations, Dobbins Seniors, Class of 2020. Amira Harrison, Tanaya Shaw, Kayla Sheaf, Mikea Smith, Alisa William, Tykira Brown, Michael Dwyer, Michelle Dwyer, Jada Flantroy, Karima Garcia Perez. Congratulations.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Angela Manning, a proud teacher and alumni here at Murrell Dobbins Career Technical Education High School. Congratulations, class of 2020. What a year and high school journey this has been. We are all proud of you. You all are now about to become alumni of Dobbins. Go Mustangs! Congratulations to Eric Jackson, Sherelle Moore, Tasmir Robinson, Shareem Rose, Zakia Sullivan, and Sadia Taylor. Congratulations.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Plaza, and I'd like to congratulate the following National Honor Society seniors on their graduation. Brianna Parrish, Kenyatta Jenkins, Sade Black, Jordan Urquhart, Tiani Long, Nyasia Gonzalez, and Jeremiah Rodriguez. Congratulations, class of 2020.
I am Murrell Dobbins, and it was a great pleasure to celebrate today. Sarabi Torn, Zahara Jenneret, Tiana Neal, Tatiana Cabrera. Best of luck.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Bruce, 12th grade English teacher from Murrell Dobbins CTE High School. I want to congratulate these new graduates from the class of 2020, Shardae Abney, Daquan Akers, Kasim Andrews, Amir Brown, Seth Goss, Anaya Monroe, Shakira White, Levina Jones, Hanif Bennett, Anthony Blake. Congratulations again. With your whole lives ahead of you, I know you are now.
Congratulations, class 2020. Jasmine Tinsdale. George Barnes. Shania Turner. Ryan Wilson. Janai Williams. Anaya
Holger. Congratulations to Murrell Dobbins CTE High School and the following students: Jordan Diaz, Tyson Hennicks, Khaled Christie, Desmond Deli, and Ariana Hill. Congratulations to you all.
Afonzia Jackson, Asenet King, Larry Jordan Flores, Mahia Jeter, Maya Driver, Naisha Harvell, Najee McCaskill, Zaniah King, Zoe Lohman.
As you have completed all of the requirements of the School District of Philadelphia and the Pennsylvania Department of Education, meeting everything that is needed to be a high school graduate, it is my privilege and honor to pronounce you graduated. Please turn your tassels from the right to the left. Congratulations, I present to you the Murrell Dobbins CTE High School Class of 2020.
Congratulations!
Go Mustangs! Go Mustangs!
Woo!
Go Mustangs!
Woo!
Go Mustangs!
Woo!
Go Mustangs!
graduated, y'all!
I'm right now, so I just can't find it.